Hello. It's Crazy Cooter. Thought I'd do a little video, put out my opinion, what I've been listening and seeing here on the news and what's going on here in the U.S. I'm down here in Texas and it's really been agitating me, getting me really concerned. It's about this gun control. I hate to tell you, I feel it's going to get worse. I mean, your First Amendment's already been in the vise. You know, there's many restrictions to your First Amendment that's unreal. Now they're trying to hit that Second Amendment. And there are some things I do agree with. I mean, the background check, we don't need people nuts, and you know they ain't all there running around toting guns. I do agree with President Perry, or not President, Governor Perry. sorry about that, but I can't believe I said that. Governor Perry said we all have the right to bear arms anywhere that we are. And, you know, I have a right to defend me and mine. That's me and my family, my property. You know, and it irritates me that a lot of people are just sitting on their butts right now, watching videos on YouTube, especially you watching this one right now. Just sitting there and life is good, peachy, and all this and stuff, and you feel comfortable in the things. You're not worried about nothing, you know, other than your damn check coming in or losing your job. But I tell you what, I mean, goodness gracious. Hey, y'all got to realize that this country, your freedoms were bought and paid for with guns. And that's with blood, sweat, and tears, and men giving their lives up to defend this country, to make it what it is today. If it wasn't for guns, I'd pretty well bet we'd be a communist, socialist country. We wouldn't be free. This would be a country underneath God, founded for God. I mean, I just hate to see that, starting with New York, I mean, every state's a little bit different, I guess, in their gun control. But this New York thing, I feel that's just the beginning. It's going to get worse. Hell, if I want to have 10,000 rounds of ammo, none of your damn business. If I want to have 100 guns or more, none of your damn business. What I do with them might be a little bit of your business, but not really. If I'm a law-abiding citizen and I'm doing right with that gun, I'm not going out there toting it in a schoolhouse or courthouse. There's several places you can't carry it in. I do agree with that. I mean, but as far as out in your own property, out and about doing your thing, you have a right to defend yourself. And you damn sure ain't, you'd be lucky to get out alive if you had a knife. If a guy's gonna come at you and threaten your life, then you have the right in the fullest extent to protect yourself. You and your family. and your property. And maybe anybody else that you don't know, this life's in danger, you know. I would be grateful that if it came to a point where, say I was in a convenience store, I was getting robbed, and I just happened to be at the wrong place at the wrong time, and maybe somebody could protect my life or my wife and kids' life if they were happen to be in there by the fullest extent of any of whatever means necessary to stop that thief, that robber who's probably toting a gun loaded to the gills with bullets and ammo. I mean, hell, I get pretty worked up on this. I mean, it's not just maybe one guy, it's two or three. I mean, I'm down there in Texas, I see the Dallas, you know, stations up there, news channels, all the robberies and stuff. Man, these guys are breaking in and busting in these stores, holding these shop owners at hostage, robbing them, stealing everything they can get. I mean, you've got to stop these criminals. I mean, these criminals are running the Second Amendment value. And you put a little lead in their pencil, and you put an end to it, you set an example that these criminals can't get away with it because honest, law-abiding citizens have that Second Amendment right to protect themselves. And that's it. I'm not going to let anybody come and take my life or anything from me. And I'll even protect you. I don't even know you. But if I have that opportunity to protect you from harm, whether they're the criminals using a gun, a knife, a ball bat, well, let me tell you, they need to stop breathing. Well, you arrest them, take them to jail, they go to jail, all the court costs and shit, and they get convicted, and hey, this guy, he's had a rap sheet longer than Santa Claus's Christmas list, you know? Just stop wasting money with these criminals, you know? Put a little lead in their pencil and stop this problem. Maybe the overall crime rate will go down. I mean, people look at guns being a problem. It's not. They help make this country what it is today. If it wasn't for guns, you wouldn't have the freedoms that you got right now. And, guns ain't really, you know, solely designed to kill innocent people. They're not designed to do that. They're designed for you to have protection, so you can protect your innocence. And, you know, besides that, you use guns to hunt. There's millions of people in this country and all over the world, millions and billions maybe, that hunt. Well, they hunt with a bow and arrow, crossbow. I mean, they can be dangerous. They can kill you. They use crossbows, bows and arrows to kill, you know, their game. So as firearms, you know, rifle, whatnot. And this idiot that I've heard blasted, you know, on the radio, that you don't need 10 bullets to kill a deer. Well, shit, what if you missed the first time? You know, What if you missed the first 9 damn times? You know? Maybe this idiot ain't never shot a gun. Maybe he ain't never, ever been hunting. Maybe he's got a good set of lips on him and he just likes flapping them. He's got a lot of hot air. So, that's just what I'm saying. I shouldn't have to sit there and reload one bullet to protect myself. One right after another. Because when seconds count, you better protect yourself as fast as you can. And you know, I don't agree that these AR-15s, I think that's a stereotyping that gun to be an assault rifle is wrong. Firearm's a firearm. And if you assault somebody with a firearm, it's an assault action that you did. I mean, you're assaulting somebody, not the firearm. I mean, people's got a screwed up mentality that just because this gun looks this way, oh my God, it's terrible. I mean, the military's carrying them around, and they're protecting your ass. They're out there taking heat, putting their lives on the line. That's what they're using. And if they got 30-round clips, 50-round clips, or 100-round drums on them things, give it to them, because they're protecting your fat, lazy ass sitting here watching videos on YouTube all day. You're out there taking your freedom for granted. Because our girls and boys in the military, I'm telling you, they're not going to do it with bows and arrows. Or little switchblade knives. They're doing it with firearms. I'm going to say, wake up, America. I mean, if you can't let the government, the people up there, keep pushing you over and over, knocking you down, spitting on you and your freedom and your constitutional rights. I don't know what else I'm going to say, but man, I just, people need to watch or listen to Rush Limbaugh. I used to think he was quiet in my younger years. But as you get older, you get wiser. I mean, them guys up there that got elected in are sitting up there in them chairs. You know, they deserve some criticism. I mean, if I don't do my job at work, I get criticized, get wrote up, or get fired. If they don't do their job up there in the Congress, the White House, or whatever, they need to get fired. I mean, that's all there is to it. Rush Limbaugh, Alex Jones, Infowarrior.com, Chris Kropp, Mark Levin, this WBAP 820 down here in Texas. It's 16:30 a.m. certain times of the day down here. I don't have shortwave radio, but I listen to local radio channels, but people start listening to their gut feeling. Their gut feeling is God inside of you telling you, you know, something's going on. Wake yourself up. And I'll bring this up. I don't know exactly where it is in the Bible, but I know it's in, I believe it's in the book of Isaiah. It, you know, don't know by heart the verse, but no weapon formed against you shall prevail. And, you know, I pray every day, every chance I get, that my biggest prayer that I say, pray to God that, you know, our military, military right now. I pray for them boys and girls over there, men and women, no matter what their age. Some of them are my age, older, younger. Some of them come home in their boots, some of them come home in a pine box. But even our police in every neighborhood around this country, that they protect me and you, the citizens of the United States. I sure hope a search and seizure of firearms doesn't happen. I don't think that's necessarily going to turn out good if that does. That's on both sides of the fence. I don't think it's going to turn out good. Maybe Congress and guys up there in the White House, the President knows. Well, sorry about the break in the film. Battery ran out on the camera, so my apologies. Anyway, yeah, 54.5 million. Oh, from 1973, that's 40 years. I don't know what to tell you, buddy. Population control, I guess. Say 1973 to right now, person be 40 years old. So, and 1.2 million. Yeah, that's a lot of damn people. Providing if they didn't die of health problems, car wrecks, accidental deaths, whatever the case may be. How many of them 54.5 million could still be alive if they grew up and be old or grow old? That's 54.5 million lives. Bitch about people getting shot with guns and killed with guns. They kill a shop owner in a robbery. Come in there pointing that gun like this, you know what I'm talking about. Three or four of them. Just last week I saw a video in Dallas. That's what they did, ganged up on them. Pointing them damn guns. Look at them. It's a bunch of dumbasses. Welfare cases. Going in there, you know, getting on that crack, that dope. Doing stupid shit. Using the gun, chicken shit. Man, if you want to rob somebody, just go in there and beat the shit out of them with bare hands. And be man enough to do that. Don't be a chicken shit and use a gun. Hell. I don't know what. People's got to change their way of thinking against the gun. I mean, a gun. You're a lifesaver. You know, hell, if they sent your ass out there to storm the beach, you get shot at. You and your troop. And you're getting your ass kicked. Guys are falling, being shot up with bullets. You'd be wishing there was a tank, a warship. Fighter jets backing you up. I said, you know, the guns have helped this country be what it is today. People over there in our military fighting for many years' freedom. But they pray for that a lot. Have reinforcement, you know. I have to say, you know, get yourself involved with God. If you ain't, if you think your life's all nice and peachy, I don't know what the hell you've been. You've been living in a closet, sucking your thumb or something. I guess your mama still changes your diaper, but grow up, start realizing what's going on. These guys up there in Washington got their little old white curly wigs on. You may not see them, but I see them wear them. Yep. I mean, our freedom just been chipped away, so I don't know. Try to wrap this up pretty quick. I'll bring up a few issues. That's about what I've been wanting to talk about. Find out. And if you don't know anything about guns, find somebody that does. Go to a gun range. Teach yourself. You know, if you don't know something, learn it. Better your not self, better your knowledge. That way you're not a dumbass out in the crowd like the rest of them. Anybody can be careless with anything. And a vehicle is pretty dangerous in its own. If you're careless with a vehicle, yeah, you can get involved in a wreck, kill some people. Goodness gracious, the gun is just as much responsibility as driving a vehicle. They have not outlawed cars or vehicles yet. More people's died in car wrecks and gun crimes. You know? The old crazy cooter, that's my 2 cents. Like it, love it. Hate it. Whatever you want to do. Like I say, if you got this far in this video, you must like it enough or you just think, you know, you enjoy what I'm saying or agree with what I'm saying. Well, anyway, if you don't like where you're at, come on down to Texas. You know, nobody holding you hostage up there where you're at. If you don't like your gun laws where you're at, just come on down here to Texas. I think we'll hold her on down here. So, anyway, we'll try to get these videos patched together. I ain't done a video in a while, so I'll say to each and one of you, pray. Get on your knees and pray. Yeah. I don't want you out there meeting your maker. You need to know who your maker is before you meet it. Before it's too late. Just stay on up and up. What's out there? There's a lot of stuff to come. Just have your ears wide open. Have your eyes wide open too. So, I feel like I might be forgetting something, but anyway. I'm just an old boy down here in the country. Down here, just thought I'd put my First Amendment rights in use. And anyway, I sure hope that this word gets out. Wake up, America. We sleeping around, laying around eating Cheetos, drinking Mountain Dew, waiting on your check to come in, your fat lazy ass watching videos on the internet. So get out there and be productive in the world. Do something with yourself. Get involved. Protect yourself. Keep this country going strong. Don't do that for me. Do it for yourself. Old Crazy Cooter, we're cutting it off. 73s. Hey, by the way, I'll just cut it off. But anyway, that right there, that's a 223. Right there. I hand loaded that. Them guys using assault rifles. Or ARs, or whatever you call them. You don't have to have an AR that shoots a 223. You can have a single shot. Or a semi-automatic, or a pump. That right there? You can't really find these now. The gun craze, this madness that's going on out there. Just say our president's the number one gun salesman. That's for sure. So, you got to pull the trigger one time per bullet you got loaded. So.